Let's examine and rank all the Breaking Bad characters introduced in Season 4 of Better Call Saul. If you haven't already, be sure to check out the earlier season videos linked now. Season 4 starts with Jimmy looking for a job. How awesome would it have been if Jimmy applied to Beneke Fabricators? Instead of Henry and Mr. Neff, he could have met Ted, his father, and maybe even their bookkeeper. What was her name?
Skylar White, yo.
So we don't get any character reveals until the next episode. I'm going to count this as the first reveal, even though we only get glimpses of him in this episode. We can see later that it's Nick, another Gus henchman. He's not memorable in either show, but he does get killed in Breaking Bad and also gets the old dissolve treatment.
So what, is this going to be a regular thing now? Meth cooking and corpse disposal? Jesus.
Just grab us a spare barrel, Walter.
Nick, rest in peace, is a D. Now for the burglar Jimmy hired to steal the Hummel figurine from Neff Copiers. It's Ira, the eventual owner of Vomino's Pest, a legitimate business that's also involved in burglaries and eventually Walt's meth production.
We're gonna do this again. I'll find something.
Sounds good. When you do, call the vet.
Yeah?
Yeah, new job, new phone. You never know who's listening.
Ira could be considered the catalyst for all of Breaking Bad, since his cell phone comment gave Jimmy the idea that created a series of cascading important events.
Mr. Ponytail on the sidewalk, that's Ira, he's the owner. The roof is Sandor, ladder's Fernando, and down below that's Todd.
And you know them how?
I've been pulling their chestnuts out of the fire, legally speaking, for 5 years. Ira and his guys are good. I mean, they know how to keep their mouths shut. If you buy them, they're going to stay bought.
Okay, here you're acknowledging that you removed all pets and plants from the house and that food has been removed or double-sealed in the bags we've provided.
Huh?
And this acknowledges that you've removed or bagged any medicines, tobacco, and pet foods. Better make sure you got any medicine you might need for the next couple of days.
It's already in the car.
Holy crap. How much poison are you using?
They did a nice job de-aging him in Better Call Saul. Still a D, though.
Yeah, just a large cheese. Yes, sliced, please. Could you also throw in some dipping sticks? 2 ranch and 1 marinara?
Now, if you take out the little listener's guide that came with the program, you'll see a chart in there showing 4 quadrants I call the time management matrix.
Venezia's Pizzeria, a real place, although later renamed to Gino's Pizza in real life, provided the famous pizza from Breaking Bad.
I thought I made myself very clear.
Got dipping sticks.
After people pointed out that it was unrealistic for the pizza to not be sliced, the Breaking Bad writers worked an explanation into the plot the following season.
Oh, yo, about time. Oh my god.
Yo, what's up with the pie, man? It ain't cut.
Yeah, right. That's the gimmick.
What gimmick?
This place, they don't cut their pizza, and they pass the savings on to you.
What savings? How much can it be to cut a damn pizza?
Maybe it's, like, democratic, bro, you know? Cut your own Christmas tree, cut your own pizza.
Yeah, it's democratic.
What am I supposed to do with this?
This pizza was also eaten by Jack and his crew, and was even referenced in a flashback in the famous Ozymandias episode.
You could take pity on us and bring a pizza home. They're having a 2-for-1 at Venezia's, and at this point, I could eat a whole one by myself.
Yeah, sure. I can pick up a pizza. Hopefully Bogdan won't get me too late.
Venezia's pizza would be higher in Breaking Bad for sure, but in Better Call Saul, it's a D. Where is Gus? That sure looks like a university.
Ruthenium, uranium, europium, zirconium, lutetium, vanadium, and lanthanum, and osmium, and astatine, and radium, and golden protactinium, and indium, and gallium, and iodine, and thorium, and thulium, and thallium. There's yttrium, ytterbium, actinium, rubidium, and boron, gadolinium, niobium, iridium, and strontium, and silicon, and silver, and samarium, and bismuth, bromine, lithium, beryllium, and barium. Oh, Mr. Fring, I wasn't expecting you.
That's not a problem, I hope.
No, not at all. I was tinkering with something.
I would like to point out that if you have any very understandable questions about the price tag, that sound, quality. At Pfizer, at Merck, that unit would be right at home. That goes for all of it.
Good. I want you to have what you need.
Well. I doff my proverbial cap to you, sir.
Gale's probably a B in Breaking Bad, but unfortunately a D in Better Call Saul.
Llegaste aquí justo a tiempo. Hold on one second. Wait. You are going to love this. I made this just for you. Nunca en tu vida has probado algo tan delicioso, ¿eh? De verdad. Mira, espérame, espérame.
You're gonna die.
Like Ignacio, Eduardo or Lalo Salamanca was mentioned by Saul in that Breaking Bad kidnapping.
No. Siempre soy amigo. Siempre, siempre soy amigo del cartel.
Shut up. I just speak English.
Lalo didn't send you? No, Lalo?
Who?
Oh, thank God.
Lalo is really fun to watch. He gave Hector his bell, he gave Crazy 8 his nickname, and caused him to be an informant for the DEA that led to Walt and Jesse teaming up. In short, he does it all. S. Did you already know these characters were from Breaking Bad? Do you agree or disagree with my rankings? Let me know.